Hi, my name's Nikki, and this is Juan Pablo. We're from Cave Urban. We're an artist and architecture collective. We started about 12 years ago now. And we started as a way to investigate natural materials and vernacular systems. And one of the first materials that we investigated was bamboo. And then it all very quickly became about bamboo because it's a very addictive giant grass that you can harvest yourself and create really big installations because it's such an exciting material.
And it's abundant. There's a lot of bamboo in Australia and nobody really uses it much. This bamboo in this work, half of it comes from Pittsridge, which is very close to Sydney. And it comes from a farm of a Vietnamese family. They actually grow it for the restaurants. They grow shoots, bamboo shoots for eating. And we harvest the poles from there. That was maybe 2 weeks of harvest.
Yeah.
Splitting it on site. And then that was half of the material of this work.
And then the other half came from another project that we did in Melbourne last year for the Rising Festival. And we had a beautiful friend that allowed us to keep it in her warehouse until this installation happened. So half of it's recycled and the other half is freshly harvested. And the thing that we love about every project is that you start with a harvest.
Kind of the journey for this particular project started talking with Jose, and he joined us the space and saying, look, this is a very big space. We need something to somehow tame the scale and be able to, you know, create little pockets for the artworks and make it, you know, more of a human scale. And then we sort of work backwards. So we work from the space to create elements that are at the scale of the space. So each one of these ribbons is roughly 20 meters long. Some of them are a meter wide, which is the width of the columns. So working with the same language, but a very drastic contrast with the material, because this is all concrete and this is just grass. So in tune with the theme of the Biennale, which was natural materials, recycled materials, we created this installation that plays with the idea of a flow. Flow is the name of the installation. And it's the flow of the river, it's the flow of the wind. It's a natural shape that was done on site. So we had a plan, but like every plan,
we had a model.
Yeah. And then
in the end, it was a very intuitive process.
Yeah.
And that idea that you can draw in the volume of space with the bamboo was very potent.
So we started from the back end there, and we created one line on the space floating, hanging from the strings. And that was sort of the guideline for the rest of the project. And interesting, when we were trying to draw that line on the ground, was really hard to get like a fluent line. And the only way of doing it was running. So running from that end to this end, when you're running, you have a direction. So even if you turn, that curve that you're describing on the floor is a smooth curve. So we draw that on the ground with chalk. And then we put each piece sort of following that line as close as possible. Not that close, but close enough, I guess.
And then one of the decisions was to use rope to hang the piece with, not wire. So it was a very manual, soft process. It was an easy process and other people could take part in it.
One of the advantages also is that we use rope before in other projects, and even though it's from a, you know, it's not a natural material, you can reuse it several times and it keeps its properties. So the rope that we use here is the rope that we'll use probably for the next 5-10 years until it breaks down with the sun, because most of our installations actually are outdoor. We like to work at a big scale, and that's perhaps the reason we've never done an indoor installation until today. And because this space is really big, it allows for doing something at the scale that we like to work, which is an architectural scale, I guess, you know, something more immersive that you can go inside, that you can experience, that you can touch, you know. And
working in here, because usually we're in the dirt, we're in the sun, we're camping, we're all together making a piece. And yeah, it was beautiful to be undercover, but still outside, still have the air and the natural feeling of the Cutaway. And it was interesting to hear from Jose about how this space actually was a forgotten space. They built the park on top and they never really thought about what this space was going to be. So this is one of the first times they've really activated it with a big installation. And that was our brief, was to make it, to fill the space so it didn't feel so cavernous.
But I remember that that first site meeting was, we're all, you know, site meetings usually, you know, just a group of people that moves, you know, without much direction, trying to recognize a site, not knowing what you want to do, but trying to kind of absorb as much as possible.
Get the landscape.
And then, you know, we saw these little rings on the roof, yeah, where you can hang stuff. And we remember asking the site manager team, so how much weight we can hang from it? You know, said, oh, you can hang 1 ton from each point. And they was like, you know, okay, we're hanging something across the whole space. You know?
Yeah.
That was sort of the spark, you know?
Yeah. And the beautiful thing about bamboo is that it's a lightweight material. So you never, we could hang many points from the one and it still wouldn't be too heavy. So it's light above your head. It doesn't feel heavy above your head. Something that we also love is that because it's representing the flow, that the artworks become like the boulders in the river, that the flow comes around the pieces and then creates its own space for each artwork. And it's been so exciting meeting all the other artists and meeting fellow grass artists. They're on the micro grass scale and we're doing large grasses, but I think we're all a grass family. And very important now to be thinking about the kinds of materials that are natural, that relate people back to the landscape and back to the environment. I know a lot of the theme of this particular Biennale is about recognizing the rights of the environment and the landscape and entities that are not us, but actually the environment that we all have to inhabit together.
What if a river could tell you something, you know? What if a river could talk, you know? What kind of stories will a river tell? And that is sort of the kind of things that are under layering all this exhibition, which is quite interesting, you know, is the voices of those entities that nowadays don't have a voice, but used to have it, you know. We used to hear nature and listen to nature, and now we sort of tend to neglect nature and try to create artificial nature or green up spaces as much as we can, rather than respecting and kind of saving those places that are naturally beautiful.
So by starting with the harvest each time, it means that we start in nature and we start by gathering in nature the things that we need to do the work.
And the beauty is that because it's a grass, I mean a giant one, the more you cut it, the greener it grows.
It loves being cut.
So you go to the forest, you cut, and then you come, you know, next year and there's double the amount of shoots, you know, and then you let it mature for 2-3 years and you can use it again. So sort of a nice cycle that we have in which the forest is looking better than when we first start working with that forest. Plus we've been able to get material to do nice installations and, you know, for people to enjoy, for people to touch natural material, to smell it, to be sort of surrounded by nature in environments where it's usually hard to, you know, like the city, for example.
And that they're ephemeral. So something that we love is the fact that you can go with the natural cycle of the landscape. You don't have to make something last for 100 years. And as architects, we're all trained to make things last 100 years, but if you listen to the seasons and you're more in tune with the natural cycle of things, then every structure should be a seasonal structure. It should be something that gets refreshed in the spring and has a natural evolution. And we've worked with a beautiful Taiwanese sculptor called Wang Wenqi, and he always works with the bamboo as an ephemeral piece as well, and we learned a lot from him. He's been incredibly generous with us in teaching us about bamboo, because as Australians we didn't have a lot of history or craft to pull on. So we actually all did a lot of traveling and writing emails to our bamboo heroes and saying, will you come and work with us in Australia? And they did, which was amazing for us.
Well, the first year when we started Kiverb, and we did a little book, a folio, which was a research folio on bamboo structures and bamboo artists, and it was sort of a little catalog, just for ourselves, really.
And what was happening all over the world, our favorite.
Whatever we thought it was exciting, we'll go in the book, and then whenever we were thinking, you know, something else goes in, something will have to come out, and sort of curating our own little
progress.
It's interesting. And then we got to meet them. We sponsored some of those artists to come over and collaborate with us. They invited us over, so we've done projects with them in Japan, in Taiwan. An artist from Belgium came over as well to teach us techniques. And
they're all very from Colombia.
Yeah, Colombia as well. Yeah, they're all very generous as well. Like, you know, sharing techniques. And as artists, it's really nice to know the know-how. You know, how do you do that? You know, and like, we're really into those little details, because that's sort of where the beauty is, you know, those little secrets when you understand how something gets made. And the interesting thing is that is, even though there's, you know, it's there's a skill to this, it's very low tech. So we were here building for 3 weeks, and we only had a couple of hand saws, some pliers, a little bit of wire, and that was it, you know, nothing else, nothing sort of out of the ordinary.